Minecraft to us was the obvious choice. So the setup is we want to study interaction with humans using language. And the way we're attempting this is through this interactive and collaborative assistant in the game of Minecraft that can interact with humans using this chat box that shows up in the game. And the idea eventually is to have an assistant that's like super fun to play with. It's fun for humans to teach and can get better and better the more humans play with it. So this is sort of the overarching problem that we're trying to study. And you know, the fact that Minecraft makes it so much more creative for us just makes it like the obvious choice for the project.
The thing about Minecraft that is really exciting for us is that the game isn't the game. It's kind of a meta game, right? People make up their own games inside of Minecraft. And if you're interested in natural language understanding, or if you're interested in kind of teaching machines, this is really useful because there's lots of players. They have lots of different ideas what to do. People are super creative, and that space of tasks that people might give an assistant is so huge and so combinatorial that despite the kind of relative simplicity of the environment, the problem is really challenging. So in Minecraft, the world is the Minecraft world, and the objects that you might talk about are the mobs and the blocks and the buildings that you've built and the trees and the water and anything else in the world that kind of you understand how the world works. So natural language understanding means that with the grounding is a tool to help you understand language and communicate, because if you want to teach somebody a new word, it really helps that you both know what a ball is.
If you can teach an assistant that can be collaborative with you, I personally see it as something that can sort of augment human creativity, especially in things like Minecraft, right? We've seen people be super creative by themselves. People build all sorts of incredibly rich structures like cityscapes and landscapes and whatnot. But having a bot that, you know, you can collaborate with and is fun for you to teach, and there's incentive for you to teach the bot because it's fun to play with, I see it really as something that can augment your creativity quite a bit.
The most interesting, unexpected thing was how good humans are at programming the bot. If you want to teach the bot, a lot of times what that means is saying the words and explaining, like writing the program that those words meant. And what we found is that players, when we kind of build the tools the right way, are excellent at programming the bot. Like, people who have no idea how the insides of it work can program it essentially as well as we can when you build the correct, you know, interfaces, which to us is super awesome. It really, I think, validates a lot of the things we're doing, and it really shows that this idea of, oh, people can teach machines in much richer ways than assigning, oh, that's a cat, that's a dog, is feasible.
Till now, the way the project was developed is, you know, a bunch of us developers were developing this, and then slowly when the bot was ready, we have this control group of people where we show them the bot and we're like, you know, can you play with the bot? There's obviously bias in there, because even these machine learning models, they learn from the data, and the data itself is biased because only a few people have learned with it. And again, we have control on this data because it's, you know, a small set of people who we've like who are skilled at this and are really, we've given them instructions to play with the bot cleanly, but it obviously is scary to us that when we just open it up to the world, you know, there can be all sorts of, like, people playing in the wild might just, I don't know, I can't even think of what the models will do at that point. But that being said, this is a research problem, and we definitely are committed to sort of enhance the state of the art in a responsible way. Right now, it's a very controlled setting, again, where the data is pretty predictable, but it's still like rich enough in that it's more natural than like me writing all the, you know, commands that I'd like to say to the bot. But going forward, it's definitely a very serious problem, and we will try our best to make sure that the data is clean and sort of unbiased as it can.
In general, when we interact with devices, we usually interact with very nice UIs that people have engineered to make it so that we can interact with them well. However, we as humans interact with each other in natural language. And there's so many possibilities that in addition to interacting with a well-designed UI, humans could really kind of teach the machine the way we teach other humans.
I think to us what's most exciting is this part of first understanding what the human is trying to teach you, to follow the instructions that the human is trying to tell you, and actually get better and better the more you interact with humans. When this is successful, you can see it going beyond this into having successful AI assistants that are fun to collaborate with.
There is so much you can do with that. That is, you know, it doesn't necessarily have to do with the assistant. It has to do with basically any electronic product you interact with.